Well, now we have Karen Wittemeyer here with us. Karen, thank you for joining me today.
I'm delighted. Thank you.
So glad you're here. You came from Texas, right?
I did, yes.
So tell us a little bit about yourself.
Okay, well, I'm Karen Wittemeyer. I write historical romance. I'm from Texas, not originally though. I actually grew up in California and came to Abilene, Texas as a student. I attended Abilene Christian University, met my husband there. We got married and we just never left. So I'm now considering myself a Texan. I have three Texas-bred children. So because of that, all of my stories are set in Texas. It's a little bit easier to research since that's where I'm located, and Texas is obviously so large that there are a lot of different places you can go, and it's very different as far as the geography and the people and the customs and all of that. So I enjoy setting my stories in Texas, and also I love writing. As a kid, I was a reader who never really thought I would be a writer, but as I grew up, people kept saying things like, you know, you're a good writer, you should consider this. And eventually I decided, you know what, maybe someday. And so I started letting myself imagine stories I might possibly write. But it wasn't until I was a stay-at-home mom with three kids and my husband found out that his job was being downsized. And we all kind of had this family panic moment of, I have to do something to help contribute to the family income. I know, I'll start writing because you can make money at that right away. 6 years later, I finally got my first contract, but that was kind of the bug that got me going. It also put me back into the regular market, so I got a job working at ACU, where I graduated from, and I started off in the testing center giving ACT tests, CLEP tests, those kind of things, and about 5 years ago I moved over to the registrar's office, so now I'm in charge of the course catalog, so I still get to play with words, which is nice. I enjoy that. It's very nonfiction side, but that's kind of what has gone on with me. My children are now grown. They're all in college, so two of them are still at ACU getting their education, and my oldest daughter is working on a PhD at A&M.
Wow, nice. Yeah, and it's an adventure. And yeah, you know, I think sometimes maybe as a reader, I think, oh, they wrote their first book, it got published right away, you know.
Right. And there are some that do have that fortunate time. Others, it takes us a long time because learning to write fiction is very different from like the academic writing you would do in college. It's a different skill set. You're not just conveying information, you're conveying emotion and creating a story world for people. And it's a little bit of a different skill set. It takes a while to learn those nuances.
Sure. Well, I got to read what I saw on your website because I really enjoyed this. It says, warm-hearted historical romance with a flair for humor, feisty heroines, and swoon-worthy Texas heroes. A firm believer in the power of happy endings and ice cream. Well, you had me sold. I'll take one of every book.
Perfect.
Yes. So what else can we find from your books? Like, what are some of the set, kind of like the, I don't know if the setting is the right word, but kind of like what's the main kind of theme, maybe.
Sure. I said feisty heroines and swoon-worthy Texas heroes because I love heroines that have gumption, right? I don't want the weepy heroine that is waiting for them to rescue. Yeah, she's going to take control. She's going to have some action. But also, my characters are very, usually they are where I would consider spiritually mature characters. I do have some that are more of on the seeker side, usually in kind of my secondary areas. But that faith element is very important to me. So I do write books that I think are a little bit more overt on the spiritual side. So you'll have characters who are seeking God's wisdom, who are looking for wisdom out of His Word or praying, and that's just part of who they are. That's kind of their core nature. I think because I want to read books that reflect my spiritual journey, and so you'll see a lot of my characters deal with spiritual struggles that I actually personally deal with as well. I think God teaches me just as much through the writing of the stories as I hope that He touches readers and allows them to experience it as well. So that's a big element of what you'll see in my stories. I try very hard to make it authentic and organic to the characters. It's never preachy. It's never agenda-driven. driven fiction. It's the story comes first, but it's a story of Christian characters and how they deal with the stresses. And just like we do in our normal life, how do we deal with the stresses that we have to face as well?
Yes, excellent. So I'm just curious, like, have you found any interesting tidbits as you're doing your research about in history?
Absolutely. So every book that I research takes place in a different place in Texas, and I haven't had a chance to visit every place that I go, but I do love having the chance to get out and go to the actual place where I'm writing the story about. There have been several, like for the last book that I wrote, which was The Heart's Charge, it takes place in Kingsland, Texas, which is in Llano County, and I had never been there before. And so while I was in the middle of writing the book, I went there, and they have a wonderful historic old hotel called the Antlers Hotel. It was built in 1901 as a place for, you know, passengers on the train that came through would stop there. My story was set a few years before that, so I couldn't actually use the hotel in my story, but staying there kind of gave me that historical feel, that ambiance. But my favorite part was there was a railroad track that went across a bridge. Kingsland itself is pretty much surrounded by water because of the Colorado River and the Llano River are both kind of coming together right there. And so it's very secluded. So back in the day, the only way to get there was to come across the railroad bridge on one side. There was another way to get in on the other side. But and so in some of my research and some old genealogical things, I discovered that there were some scary moments that happened on this bridge as passengers were going. So I knew I needed to, you know, find this bridge. I needed to take pictures of it. I even kind of bravely walked a little bit on it. There's no trestles or anything. It's just a plane, you know, so I didn't walk very far. I was like, I do not need to end up, you know, in the river. But it was fun just to be there and see this bridge that's been standing since the time of my story and to feel like I'm walking where my characters walked. It just helped it bring it to life a little bit more as I was writing those scenes. But digging into the research and finding real things that I can kind of twist and add my own fictional take on it for my characters is always fun. I had a story set in Gainesville at the Harvey House Cafe that was there, and it's still standing there. I was able to go and see the imprint on the floor where the counter used to be. I was able to go upstairs and see a room they had set up for where the Harvey girls would stay. And so just having those experiences just adds that layer of authenticity to the stories that I can't get just from, you know, Googling stuff and finding it online.
Sure. And this may seem like a dumb question, but I don't know what the Harvey girls are.
Okay. So they started late 1800s as a product of the railroad, basically. So Fred Harvey was one of the first chain restaurant entrepreneurs. So he figured out if you can put places for people to stop and eat as the train is coming through, a lot of the places were just these very basic stops and the food was horrible and, you know, people did not enjoy it. But he made a point to have these pretty much high-end, you know, restaurant places, but they were timed to the second for the train to come through because people had to get off, eat, get back on, and, you know, make sure they're not missing their train. And so he had all across the Santa Fe Railroad, wherever it stopped, he would have these places along the routes for passengers to be able to get off and eat and then come back on. And so there were a few that were also in Texas. They didn't have a lot that came through Texas, but there were a few. And there was one that stopped in Gainesville and had a place there. It was a little lunch counter, so it wasn't quite the fine dining. It was a little more casual. But it was very interesting because the Harvey girls in some places, because they were waitresses who lived upstairs, people assumed that they were like saloon girls who lived upstairs and had rooms upstairs. And so a lot of times the locals would look down on them, even though Fred Harvey made a big point of you have to be a virtuous woman to work this position. They wore these very strict uniforms that covered them from neck to, I mean, there was no way these women were not, you know, they were not red light district ladies. But sometimes the locals still thought that way. And so it was kind of fun to be able to work kind of that angle into the story that I was telling and kind of the conflict that she had to deal with. But yeah, they were really an interesting bunch of women, very brave, pioneering. A lot of them came from back east and were working their way across the west. And so another just kind of, you hear of women coming and civilizing the west, you know, the Harvey girls were kind of part of that, that, you know, were single women that came out and helped civilize the west. So,
you know, and that's why I love reading these types of books is learning so much. And I've kind of said this in the past in other interviews that it's kind of like I'm tricking myself into learning.
That's right. That's right. Well, when I was a kid, I mean, I loved historical novels. That was my favorite thing to read. And part of it was the learning. I learned a lot mm-hmm. of history through the stories that I read. And in fact, I actually hated history in high school because it's all wars and dates and politics. I really don't like politics. And I just want the stories. I want Little House on the Prairie. I want Anne of Green Gables. That's what engages me. And so now as an author, it's fun to learn those little tidbits of history that are interesting to me, not the ones that people tell me I have to learn.
Yes, so. Yes. So what do you have coming up in the future?
So my current series is called the Hanger's Horsemen series. It's a group of four ex-military cavalry officers who are now kind of on a pursuit of justice. So they kind of go, it's the A-Team meets the Magnificent Seven. So you have, you know, the four ex-military guys that are going around trying to find justice for those that can't find it for themselves. So the first two books are already out. I'm currently writing the third book. It's supposed to be turned into my editors later in August, so hoping that one gets finished on time and turned in. But that'll be the third book, the final book of the series, and then I'll be starting something new after that.
Super. Well, thank you so much for joining us today. I greatly appreciate it, and thanks for sharing your gifts of writing. So
thank you so much for having me. It was really a joy.